This deck is called after the eponymous card Gate Guardian. Even by today's standards, Gate Guardian is one of the monsters with the heftiest summoning requirements in all of Yu-Gi-Oh! He's also one of the worst boss monsters in terms of risk-reward ratio, yet is one of the most iconic monsters, which genuinely amazes me still to this day. On to the facts. Gate Guardian is a level 11, 3750 attack, warrior-type effect monster that cannot be normal summoned or set. Even worse, he can only be special summoned by tributing three specific different level 7 monsters from our side of the field. Then Gate Guardian can be summoned from our hand. But apart from that intricate summoning condition, he has no effect. He has no built-in protection. He is a plain vanilla beater. That's why summoning him emotionally equals winning the duel, even though he's far from granting us a simple victory. Nevertheless, I played two copies of him. I also maxed out on the three monsters we have to have on field in order to summon him, namely Sangha of the Thunder, Kazijin, and Zuijin. They all are, by GOAT standards, fairly strong tribute monsters, not only stats-wise, but they also share the effect of being able to reduce the attack of one opposing monster attacking them to zero. This effect is unfortunately a once per card effect, but still makes them hard to beat over with any potential threat. This deck's goal is to bring these three monsters out as fast as possible and should hence be named Sangha, Kazijin and Zuijin Turbo instead of Gate Guardian, since the latter is rarely ever brought out in a real duel. For tribute fodder, I only play three copies of Nimblemonga, which is a floater that gives us some life points. And that's about it, because we primarily want to use opposing monsters as tribute fodder. I chose double Brain Control for that reason, and double Soul Exchange. Next, I play two level reducing cards. First one being the self-explanatory Cost Down, second being the trap card from the Lost Millennium, Level Conversion Lab. Which lets us roll a dice, and if the result is 2 till 6, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6, the level of one monster in our hand becomes equal to the result, meaning we are very likely to normal summon it without tributes required. Level Conversion Lab could easily fit into other tribute summon decks, like Ancient Gears for example. Tribute Doll is the next card. Tribute Doll lets us also summon Sangha, Kazijin or Zuijin with only one tribute. Monster Gate is the main reason why, aside from the three boss monsters, we play so few monsters in this deck, because this increases the chance to summon any of the boss monsters straight from the deck. For Monster Gate targets, apart from the Nimble Momongas, I picked two copies of Scapegoat. Scapegoat tokens are also convenient fodder for Tribute Doll, as Tribute Doll special summons the level 7 monsters, so Scapegoat tokens are not used for a tribute summon. For We Play Monster Gates, I also included one the Warrior Returning Alive, so as to recover Gate Guardian from the grave, if it has been sent there by Monster Gate. If we drew too many level 7 or higher monsters, we can stack them back into the deck, shuffle it and draw one card once per turn by using lighten the load. By using lighten the load. Cyberjar is there to collect many resources in our hand. And next up are Pot of Greed and Graceful Charity. No delinquent duo in this one. Snatch Steal fits well into the equation of tributing opposing monsters instead of our own. And Premature Burial and Call of the Haunted special any of the three boss monsters from our grave. That's it for the deck. As always, the decklist can be found in the video description. I hope you enjoyed it and thank you for watching.